And welcome, and welcome to this lecture of Maurizio Carta. Maurizio, well, it's a pleasure to have you, Maurizio, with us. I was sure, because we are friends, and always it's a pleasure to be with friends. But in fact, I was thinking that I was 5 days ago in Lebanon, and another common friend, José Manuel Madrigal, that he knows you, and introduced me and Mose Ricci. As he said, Mose Ricci and Manuel Gausa, they are activists of the urbanism, and the vast activist is a little guerrillero, but in fact I can start with the same thing. You are an activist of the cities, no? And activist of the knowledge of the cities, and in fact Maurizio, in fact is a, I don't know the word, probably is activist in the sense that he's convinced of his actions and his experiences and his the operations that you have tried to do in your life. But in fact, this idea of activism is not bad, because I think that you try to work in different formats. This is the thing, to explore and research about our contemporary environments and habitats. In fact, Maurizio is evidently a full professor of urbanism. This is the first thing. He's engaged in the education, but also he's a producer of urbanism. He's a planner. He's acting in operational situations. He was involved and also in political aspects of the city, in the administration too. Don't be only in the academical or in the professional world, but also in the public world, linked with the social situations of his city, Palermo, because he's from Palermo, he's full professor in Palermo University, and also at the same time he's a writer, he's a lecturer, he writes a lot of books, he tried to do also meetings, conventions, manifestations to, in fact, just this. Why not diffuse, produce, and also why not celebrate the ideas of the new environments, or urban environments. And I think this is, for this reason, when I knew you, not a lot of years, but it was an enormous feeling of with Maurizio, because also it's another thing very important. He believed absolutely in the capacity of the Mediterranean knowledge to be a leadership and to be in leading processes of innovation in our culture, our contemporary culture. And I think it's very important to be proud of yourself and proud of your origins and try to do a new knowledge that is not always in the conventions of, I don't know, foreign situations. And I think that this was in the base also of the IaaC Foundation, this capacity to be global, to understand the global situations of the world, and to be local, and to be trying to have a step here, very local, but in connection with global movements. I think it's the same for you. You are very interested in the cultural dimension of the architecture and the urbanism. Maurizio was so in Italiano, non lo so, però, responsible of culture, of cultural politics of Palermo, and I think this dimension of space, architecture, urbanism, and culture is in the base also of the IaaC, no? To understand that the architecture is not only profession, is not only a discipline, is culture. In fact, it's a collective adventure, a collective cultural adventure. Well, thank you, Maurizio. In fact, the other thing today is to celebrate this book. In fact, this is the official presentation in Barcelona of this new book, Reimagining Urbanism, who is the last book of Maurizio, practically is niente. 2 days published. In fact, it's true, eh? It's 2 days or 1 day published. And we have the honor to be practically the first city that we are presenting this book in public for our students and for our guests. And for us it was very important, because this idea to work with a reinvention of the city and the discipline, the urban discipline, is also in the in our agenda. For this reason, thank you very much, Maurizio, to be with us. I know I read the institutional curriculum of Maurizio Carta. Maurizio Carta is an architect and full professor of urbanism and regional planning at the Department of Architecture of the University of Palermo. He's the head of the master in urban and regional planning, also in the University of Palermo. He has been member of Italian Society of Urban Planners Steering Committee in the 2000 and 2003, and he's senior expert in strategic planning, urban design, and local development, and he was also the author of several urban landscapes and strategical plans in Italy. Also, for example, in Palermo, you have a very important strategical directional plan. No? He's the responsible of the Smart Planning Lab, and for improving the smartness of cities and communities. And he was visiting scholar at Columbia University of New York in 1998. And he was also visiting professor or keynote speaker in several universities and institutions. In fact, I cross you a lot in different scientific manifestations in the world. He's author of several publications, among the most recent, one I think is absolutely interesting and I recommend you is Next City, Culture City. And in fact, it's the same title of the summer school, Global Summer School of this year, Next City. The editor is Meltemi, 2004. Creative City, perhaps is your bestseller, I don't know, the Creative City, the three cities. Exactly, List, Barcelona, 2007. Governare l'Evoluzione, Milano, Franco Angeli, 2009. Rethink, Reload, Recycle, Mediterranean Urban Metamorphosis, Le Carré Bleu, 2013. And this Reimagining Urbanism, List, Barcelona and Trento, 2014. That is the last book, as I say, and I imagine that you will present these contents that are always in relation with this adventure of the innovation of the urban approach beyond the disciplines in a transversal, with transversal keys and with new cultural paradigms that are, in fact, building our knowledge. And, well, thank you very much, Maurizio, and enjoy. Enjoy these days.
Thank you, Manuel, for your presentation. You are my friend and you lies. Thank you for the invitation, and for me it's a pleasure to be here, because this is an important, fertile occasion to discuss with you about the need to reimagine urbanism, because you are one of the place that I seen as a leadership when I speak about in other place, and it's important for me talk about other experience, other place with you. I prefer. Yes. Please cut off when you are tired and when I spent all my time. First reflection. Urbanism often say to the people, don't think to a crocodile. But the result in this room now is the crocodile. We must pass a vision based only prohibition. But urbanism must recover a vision based on more recycling, more design, more sharing. So, we need for a new education of vision, for improving a new ecology of mind. So I use this, the Ludovico Friedman, do you remember the Clockwork Orange, to re-educate our vision, the urbanist vision. So, I think, I feel we need to reimagine urbanism. Because we live in a metamorphosis age, we don't live only in a crisis age. We live in a metamorphosis age. What kind of metamorphosis? A lot of kind, a lot of image, and a lot of type of metamorphosis. But I would focus about this. This is a recent issue of The Economist in January of this year. And this dossier, this report, point that we are in a new Cambrian revolution after 500 million years. A new Cambrian revolution, a new explosion of a new life in our planet. Which kind of revolution? Which are the new organisms? Those. The fab labs, the incubators, the co-workers, the co-housers, the startuppers, the smart citizen, and so on. But is it sufficient? This new architecture and urban organism are sufficient to define, to improve this Cambrian explosion? I think no. Because we need a new creative urban ecosystem, not only new organism. Which kind of ecosystem? I use this book of Steven Johnson, Where Good Ideas Come From, The Natural History of Innovation. I suggest to you. Johnson said that open environment and shared platform increase profitability and creativity of the people involved. And Johnson indicate to us three principal type of creative habitat. The first, the coral reef, a place with the most deep of biodiversity in the ocean, a place in which the life is the cooperation between among the various type of fish, of plants, of coral, and so on. A piece, an island of biodiversity inside the homogeneous of the ocean. The second type of creative habitat is the web, the place where the sharing is the DNA of the web. Third, the city. Coral reef, web, and the city. And the integration of three types of a creative habitat make our vision, our issue, our mission as an architect, as an urbanist, as an engineer, as a designer in the complex sense. The coral reef, the city, and the web, as seen in this type of habitat, as seen great invention come to light, resulting about on the a relation based on cooperation. Innovation is born from the relationship, the sharing, and the hybridization of ideas. But I think, with Matt Ridley, that the city is the best place where ideas have sex. This is the city, the place in which ideas, several ideas, make sharing, hybridization, integration. This is a conceptual map of topics, of cultural sector. This is, for me, a good map of the relation in a city. So, urbanists have to design the new alliance between human capitals, creative cities, and smart citizens. We have to use the left brain and the right brain, the rationality and the creativity, both. The evidence of this. We are in phase of the rise of the new civic tech, the integration between the civic sense and the technology. So the civic tech has generated the government data, the collaborative consumption, the crowdfunding, the social networking, the community organizing. This is a new kind of to be citizen, to be people in a city. But also the mapping is changing. These are the city map drawn by the runners. What say this map? Only where the runner run? No. This map say to us the security, the sense of security of the place, the quality of the place, the significance of the tissue in the frequency of the running use, or the orientation, the solar orientation of the street. What is said? The warm, the cold, the solar, the energy efficiency of the city. Or this, the big data, the open data, begin design, begin sound, begin arts. This is the habit of Hanover. But we think that smart city need intelligent people, because this is the danger. It's no explain. Not just add technology, but we need to rethink the city, the way in which we lie in the city. But this is perception, our think or reality. This is a cover of the Bloomberg Business Week, the difference between perception and reality. It's evident. Some vision. We live in a world of city. We are an urban planet. But the city, the cities, is not only the winner against the rural space, the landscape space, the non-urban way of settlement. Because in this urban planet, the city has the responsibility of the winner, the responsibility to indicate new settlement model, new ethic way to stay in the planet, the responsibility to reform itself as a winner. Which is the current urbanism paradigm? In most Mediterranean city, in most Mediterranean place, in my place, in Palermo, in Sicily. I don't know in Barcelona, perhaps. This one, the Luigi Galvani experiment on the dead frog, The illusion of the dead frog show that a dead organism could reborn by an external electricity. But it's illusion, it's an aporia, a light truth. Because no external resource can rebirth a dead organism. We have to find the vital resource, the life resource inside the organism in decline or death. So we have to plan in a metamorphosis age. Metamorphosis is the new and powerful keyword in time of crisis, because metamorphosis asks to go out from the crisis different from when we have entered. So we have to plan in the urban age, because the metamorphosis will have to be mainly urban. But what is the meaning of crisis? In Greek, in ancient Greek, crisis means selection. We have to recover the ability to select. So, in the city, we have to recover the social capital, the complex meaning of social capital. But which kind of city? These are the city. 20% of the planet are urban land. 53% of people live in the city. But the 80% of carbon are emitting from the city. But also, the city produces 50% of world urban GDP, and produce the 75% of the creativity profit. These are the city. People, footprint, and profit. In Italy, this is the situation. We have transformed. In 1956, we have 2.8% of urban land. Now, in 2010, we have 6.9% of city of urban land. With a dramatic velocity of the consumption of the land. This, a dramatic Pac-Man that consume 8 square meter per second. So, the urban agenda of the European Union has elaborated new keywords to answer to this question, to this issue. This one, do you know? Urban metabolism, green economy, social cohesion, smartness, recycle, public-private partnership, resilience, transitional city, and so on. The toolbox of the urbanism are heavy. But find the difference between this and this. We need an holistic approach, not the segmentation, the separation of the tools, but the need to integrate these keywords. But in Mediterranean cities, Mediterranean area, we have a changing paradigm. This paradigm serves to defeat four main pathologies. The first, the autism. Because the urban policies, the urban regeneration policies seems as an autistic, men or women, with rationality, but a rationality closed in the next context, in the near context, not able to relate with other elements of the city. The second pathology is the schizophrenia, consisting of the constant change in approach and policies, in aim to follow different suggestion, project, vision, and so on, funds, and so on. The third pathology is sterility, of course, which is translated into low value added of the or non-existent multiplier of investment, the principal resource of the urban regeneration project. Fourth pathology is drug addiction by public funds, by public resource, in particular in Italy. So, because relational are the pathologies, relational have to be the answer. So we have reconnect the relationship. These pathologies are spread in the decision making policies, in the people answer or in the people question. So we have to restart from the city. We need to reactivate the real urban metabolism, not only the technological metabolism or the physical metabolism, but the complex metabolism. We have to reactivate the world urban return on investment, the ability of the city to make value, to generate value. So we have to rethink public policies. We have to empower private actors. We have to reactivate urban cycles. The cities appears as a system, as a mechanism, as a computer that is wrong, appears wrong. But their disk is good, some good. The memory is sufficient for the function. The case is good, is not wrong. But something is not correct. Often we need to reboot. We need to reload the operating system and the computer rebirth. So we have to recover, we have to find the vital factors of the city, the part of the city in which the life is still strong. We have to reload the urban operating system. But which kind of cities? the megalopolis, the metropolis? Perhaps. But this is our challenge. The rise of the middle cities. Not only the megalopolis, but that city that have creativity, that have interaction, culture heritage, innovation, problems. The so-called second-level cities. But to act on those cities, we have to redefine some paradigms about them. We have a lot of paradigms in this. Last month, Moserici talked with you about the new paradigm. I won't use some paradigm, two or three. The first, the creative paradigm. The creative paradigm is a deep paradigm, is a usual paradigm, but we have to redefine it, passing from the first generation of the creative city, based only on the attraction of creative class, the Florida model, through the second generation of the creative city, based on the generation of creative class inside, to the creative city 3.0, the third generation, based on the activation of a creative ecosystem. This is an example in which education is the engine, economy is the fuel, culture is the oxygen, networking is the ignition, so communication is the explosion. This is a scheme of creative ecosystem, a new alliance between governance and connectivity, a new governance and a spreading connectivity in which we involve creative talents, creative industries, and creative space, like this. So, I have elaborated a 4C model for creative city, for creative ecosystem. The first C is city. The second C is culture. The third is communication. The fourth is cooperation. This is the main factor, and the relation among these is the internal engine, internal fuel for the creative city. This is my scheme. The old creative capitals, Florida paradigm, talent, technology, and tolerance, begin the creative city, culture, cooperation, and communication. And now they interact between the six elements of the smart city: living, environment, people, governance, mobility, and economy. Second paradigm, the maker's paradigm. You are makers. The economist. Again, two years ago, the first about the third industrial revolution, in which bit and atom play together. The second a true progressivism in which the top-down policies and bottom-up policies play together. Today, Makers is a wide way of to stay, to make city. But I would show you some Mediterranean southern experience. This is in Sicily, Favara, the Farm Cultural Park. A friend of mine, Andrea Bartoli, has regenerate the old town using the contemporary art. Now, this experience is one of the most important in Sicily. It wins some prize at the community as has begun the partnership of the Andrea. The second, Matera, the monastery project, in which a community of digital native, digital people helps ancient people to use the digital technology to make something, to repair some device or to ask to call, to relate with the administration. Third, the hub. This is the hub of Bari. Not only a co-working place, but a place that relates with the administration and reuse some big place. This is the fairs, the Levante fairs, that the administration it's have no idea, in which the administration have no idea to reuse. Ferrara, the Spazio Grisù, a co-working place in that has been generating a new community of entrepreneurs, of young entrepreneurs, in not only in digital enterprise, but in mechanical enterprise, in hard enterprise. Trento, Progetto Manifattura by Kengo Kuma, the same place, a place that keep together institutional partner and private partner. Third, the energy paradigm. This is important for us, you know. The Europe has set up the 2050 strategy, the new strategy for the Europe. This is the actual scenario of the distribution of energy with the principal backbone, and the white point are the place of consumption, the place of demands. This is the next scenario in which consumption and distribution coincide in the same place, changing the way in which we design, manage and distribute the energy. A new ecological symbiosis. This is a project of big. This is our future, I think. These are the Pink Floyd you recognize. But I think, we think, with Manuel, with Mosè, with other, that there is a rising paradigm, the recycling urbanism. We see some phenomena of this paradigm, because we have to plan in the recycle age. This is Michelangelo Pistoletto in Biennale di Venezia. This
works is called Italia Riciclata.
It's necessary to recycle city using the city mines, the scrap, the fragments, the chips of the city. The several scraps, chips, fragments, pieces out of use. Lacatone Vassal for the frack in Dunkerque, this mirror of the reuse of the old building in the harbor, or this project for a container building branding, or the new Fresh Hill Park in New York on the old landfill. So we have to hypercycle the city, not only recycle. We need to activate hypercycle, because the city change, the city shrinks. Detroit, you know, but not only Detroit. Detroit is a paradigm, but in our city, our Mediterranean city, in Palermo, in Barcelona, in other place, in Naples, and the disused area, the abandoned area, the vacant land, for me, are as a blastema. What is the blastema? The blastema in biology is a not specific group of cells that begin to interact, and then it become an hand, an arm, a leg, the heart. They don't know what will be, but begin to interact. I would show you three visions for three cycles. First cycle, the flexible cycle. The keyword is resilience. We have a lot of experiments. Copenhagen, the Sankiel district, are resilient in the street in which the water begin material of the project with a complex redefine of the green space, the fluid space, the public space, and so on. Or the Rotterdam Water Plaza, in which the water of the storm water begin not a danger but project with this manual of use, the way to use the space, the public space in different occasion, the dry situation after heavy shower, after a downpour, or the competition for the resilient New York. This is the big project, very interesting, because they redefine the waterfront of New York in order to make it more flexible, resilient, not resistant to the storm or to the hurricane. Second cycle, the knowledge cycle. We have a lot of examples, but I show you one, a little example, but interesting. The new Mediatek of the Mont de Marsan that won't become an educative city, not only an education service, but the entire city became educational, with public space, private space, open space, and closed space without separation, without barrier.
this is a piece of mediatek or a place or a plaza. It's the same. This is a bibliothek or a coffee or internet cafe. It's the same. Third cycle, remote, the digital cycle. For smarter and creativer citizenship. Paris, some experiment of a digital device, a urban digital device, very interesting, is self-sufficient, it produces the energy for itself. Paris too, the Gately Rig, the regeneration of the old theater to become an intelligent building that speak, that talk with the public, with the, through the RFID chips, or Lady Singapore, you know, or this is a artistic project, very interesting, is Patricio Gonzalez Vivo, that reproduce the cloud of the information inside the Google Maps. We see the map of the Google Maps, but that maps contain a lot of information about the building, about the street, about the people, about the a lot of information that are disappeared. And last digital cycle, you, of course. But an answer, an important answer, an important question, sorry. This is a mantra or a project? We need to repeat this paradigm, this concept, or we have to design, we have to project. So I have bring some challenges of mine, my experiments. The first, the experiment on recycle. This is a piece, a part of a complex national and international research. Manuel is one of the part of this. Recycle Italy, a big research project. More than 100 people are involved, 150 I think. 11 universities and several institutions, private administration, and so on. In Palermo, we are thinking and acting about a map of the recycle areas, and we call it Palermo Reverse. This is Palermo Reverse, in which is not important the traditional part of Palermo. Important in the white part there is the history of Palermo, I know, but for us is important the gray part, this Palermo reverse, this Palermo that would regenerate, that would rebuild the inside fuel, the internal source of regeneration. These are the area. These are the different cycle, the brown cycle, the green cycle, the blue cycle, the gray cycle of infrastructure, the red cycle of the housing, the cultural center, and so on. Then we are going to focus in a part, the so-called former gasometer, that is an interesting part of the city, in front of the sea, with our little river, and so on. These are our elaboration, in which we redefine the the way of representation, the scheme of representation with several filters. And these are our vision. No fragmentation, no impermeabilization, no cars. These are the vision. This is the project of the former gasometer in order to make a innovation district in collaboration with the university, with the enterprise incubator of the city. These are some pictures. And we are going to elaborate some tools, design tools and policy tools. These are the most important. The setup of urban recycle district, the setup of recycle covenants, the activation of laboratories agency with shared responsibility, and a new urban fiscality, urban management with compensation, equalization, and taxation and incentives. Second experiment, reload the smart planning lab, university research center, able to define, able to study the concept of smart city, but to define some operational tools, not only some paradigms or rhetoric. This is our objective. Smart means specific, so we have to elaborate some vision, measurable, we are working about sensors, achievable in terms of skills and tools, realistic in terms of assessment, and time-markable in terms of protocols. This is the scheme of our work, a sort of smart planning protocols, in order to improve smart tool and city apps in various levels. And this is our first experiment of map. This is a map that brings together the traffic generated by goods in that timetable, time sector of the day, and the road congestion. The first experiment in Palermo. Other sector of day, traffic generated by schools and road congestion. Third, traffic generated by work and road congestion. Often, no relation. And this is, for Palermo, the first energy map, energetic map, in which we have to map the consumption of the electric energy. The light blue is high value, and the place in which the administration has localized the photovoltaic roof. No relation. Third, reboot. This is the most recent experiment. This is Poggio Reale, one of the city of the Belice that was destroyed in the earthquake of the 1968, completely destroyed. And in the next year or from the earthquake, some urbanists make this plan. A strange plan that the administration now asked to me and to my equipe to redefine the master plan. And the first question was, but because it's wrong, it don't the function, the urban fashion don't wrong because the population go away. So I think that this plane and this city built following this plane is a sort of a broken mechanism, a piece of mechanism broken. Like this. This is the machina of Antichitera, an ancient mechanism, a Greek culture mechanism found in the Aegean Sea. And nobody knows what it is, what is it. So I think that that plane is a part of a more complex mechanism, but something wrong. So my plan, my master plan, aim to define the user manual. I think that someone has lost the manual of that plan. And these are the different instructions to reactivate the city, about the smart cycle, about the green cycle, about the living cycle, and about the rest cycle. In particular, we are trying to redefine the role of this city in the complex context of the Belice. This is the actual situation. It seems a ghost town. They have lost the user manual. This is Paolo Portoghesi. So, in conclusion, we need some commitments. Because reimagining urbanism is not merely a disciplinary or technical operation, but becomes a fundamental chromosome for the new metamorphosis age. First commitment, promoting city livability, landscape quality, cohesion of inland areas, environmental sustainability, and energy efficiency as a priority of the European urban agenda. The second commitment is accelerating the new metropolization process determined by the changes in economics and so on. The third commitment is including new creative city sensibility and paradigms within town planning, including inside the town planning scheme and town planning paradigms. The fourth, reviewing, in particular in Italy, the public-private relationship. The fifth, renewing designer and planner tools. We need new tools, not only new vision or value. We need in Italy new tools, new device, new instrument. So, for me, reimagined urbanism need more vision, more strategy, more project, more rules, more community. How? I'm not alone. I have a lot of friends that I've defined
some piece of this shared reflection. But if you want, you could dip on my book. Thank you so much.
In time.
Now if you agree, we start a little debate and questions
or something. I'll start and after we continue. Well, thank you very much. It was amazing. It was a fantastic agenda. Manifesto and at the same time operational decalogue to act today. We are evidently, thank you also for your mention to the IaaC. Evidently we are in this agenda and we are absolutely near of this vision that believe this new paradigm approach. And it was very clear, it was absolutely very clear your presentation, but also it's full of suggestions and very well expressed. I have some thing that it's a question, and another thing that is a little caprice, you know, but the first is in the presentation, it was very clear the idea of a new cycle that it's not only recycled, that that's a hypercycle, that is a new cycle of cycles, no? And it was a moment very interesting to try to perhaps to explore. It was when you say the important in these situations of share, exchange, culture, city, of the interaction between elements. And I was thinking that one of the revolutions is the transfer between the compositional vision to a dispositional vision, the importance of the dynamic in all this, and the information as a part of an interaction and a part of a dynamic process. For all this is in the base of this new situation. And this is not a question, but something to explore or to try to profundize, to deep?
No, to
yes. If you want to talk a little about it, because I think that is in the base of all this thing. The other thing, this is my personal caprice, is that evidently in all this you have two things. One is the research, the need to research and to explore these new paradigms, and you are in educational, in the culture is part of this, the culture not as erudition but a creative situation, a proactive situation, research. The other thing is, I think, the conviction of the capacity to have examples, I don't know, inductors, catalysators of this, and for this you show all these examples, your own experience, our experience, etc., as part, but of this holistic research. This is interesting, but because I know, and you know that is my little thing, and they didn't know, you have a fantastic thing that is in this idea of interaction, research, cultural experiences, etc. We can change the things, because the first idea is, well, perfect, research, cultural, but how to change the decision of the things. We are in politics, you are in politics, etc. I think in your case is more about this capacity to do a lot of effects, and the effects interact between themselves, and the effects between themselves try to change the situation. And this operational interaction, I believe, in fact, is my idea, that you work with different formats, educational, cultural, why not, political, etc. Doing, you multiply, and at the end you change the situation to have the capacity to decide and not only to think. No? And for this, in the Mediterranean situation, that, as you say, is more difficult, Maurizio have a theory that is fantastic, and if you can explain them, that is the zero, how to work without anything, without anything. I think in this is not only a joke, because it's the capacity to interact within, without possibilities, but by multiplication. And this is my little caprice, if you can explain it to our guest and our expert, because I think it's the same in other aspects of your culture, this to be, and also the things that we are doing here, this is a little space of research, but we do a lot of things, but multiplying the interactions between these and a global sharing situation. This is my, I don't know if you are going to explain or to, but I hope yes.
I spent 1 hour to answer to your question. No. I think the answer is we have no other possibilities, because we have no more external electricity to rebirth the dead frog, or the frog that is with some problem. Manuel says my said my 4-0 theory. I use in other occasion this this example, which are the number that characterize the situation of the current situation of the public administration in Mediterranean or European, except the Germany administration. The first number, what is the amount of the public funds in the public balance for investment, for urban regeneration? Zero. There are no money for investment. Perhaps there is money for the current. Second, in Italy, I speak about Italy. No, I don't want to speak about your situation or other situation. In it, I leave you to speak about Catalonia or other. The second, which is the actual multiplier of investment of urban regeneration in Italy, in southern Italy, is zero. In other part of the world is 300%, in other part is 500%. In our reality is zero. The real, not the potential. Third zero, the facilities, the management facility in various, in different taxation or other, in Italy is zero. We have a law scheme, a law framework that sterilizes the facilities, the administrative facility. And the last number, the fourth zero, is about the integrated multiplier, the integrated return on investment, the ability of urban generation to amplify other sectors. The sector of research, the sector of material, the sector of enterprise, and so on. Zero. Our administration, in front of this 4-0, said, smiling, perhaps, annoying and smiling. But Albert Einstein said, insanity is make always the same thing, expecting different results. The problem is no combine zero plus zero plus zero plus zero. But understand that inside that zero, and combine in different way the zero, I could bring another result. In mathematics, zero plus zero done zero, make zero. But zero elevated to zero make one. So zero elevated zero plus zero elevated zero for zero make two. And with two is better than zero. So the answer, in the rhetoric answer, but not only rhetoric, is rethink, plan different, or think different. Because the situation, for several years, that for zero remains zero. We don't make wait for the for other number of starting, but if we recombine the often dramatic situation, we have to produce different result. About the cycle, the difference between hypercycle and recycle. Recycle is clear. The hypercycle, the concept of hypercycle for us is that the city is a sum, is a have a lot of cycle, the water cycle, the energy cycle, the waste cycle, but they act as different layers. And for each layers, there is a specialist, there is a sectoral administration, there is a designer or a planner. But there are not different layer. There are the one only layer, the city. Because the city birthed for the interaction of the layer. When the first man wake up and thought the city was because we have to make interaction between a settlement, a market, the security, the management of waste, and so on, and in particular, the generation of innovation. Remember Matt Reggie. The city is the best place where different sector have sex.
Not for Simon, yes. Well, you have questions?
Well, thank you for the very lovely presentation. I have a question about the relation between the public and private sectors. Where does the role of the public sector maybe not stop, but maybe decrease, so as to give the possibility for the for the private sector to achieve the growth, the economic growth, or all the growth that we were talking about? This is first. Second, about the sustainability. For me, I think sustainability is more than the technicalities of a building or a city, like how the city works in the course of saving energy or all these things that you mentioned. It's also about the user and how he receives this perception and how he accepts it and how he actually applies this sustainable way of living onto his city. So where can the architect in this case interfere so as to achieve also a sustainable city with its users and its design?
The current situation, the most diffused situation of the private public-private partnership is a line that separate public and private. And the struggle is, when I put the line, 10%, 20%, 30%, 50%, I have arrived. Inside each part, the public make the same thing of the private, only with a smaller or higher composition. It's not correct. The difference is the action the public have to retake the vision role and regulatory role. Is the director, not the actors, the light expert on all other. So the different is not a line, but the different is the skills, is the competence, is the ability to act, is the representation, because the public is representative, is elected, he has the mandatory of by the citizen. I think this have to be the difference, not the best place when I take a line.
Limit because they must stop. Well, another question?
I make the tourists during the day.
Yeah. Well, they're working a lot because they're finishing a lot of things. Well, no questions more? Well, what? We have now, yes, exactly, informal questions here in our aperitivo to celebrate your lecture, Maurizio, and thank you very much, and enjoy the aperitivo. Thank you.